There are some great new features in SolidWorks Sheet Metal 2024. This cargo carrier attaches to the trailer hitch of a car or truck and be used to haul the Bowhead RX around to nearby trailheads and rides. The entrance swings open and turns into a ramp so that the Bowhead can be rolled on and strapped down for transport. You can see that there is a diamond plate sheet metal liner with some indents for the wheels to sit in. Let's see how we use some of the new features of SolidWorks Sheet Metal 2024 to help design this liner. Taking a look at the liner, we can see that it's incomplete and still needs one of the side plates to finish the design. We are in an assembly and all of the sheet metal parts are connected using the tab and slot feature. Let's use copy with mates to copy the long side to the other side of the liner. We'll repeat this first mate and use the front and right assembly planes to finish mating this part in place. When zooming in, we can see that there are tabs from the copy part, but no slots on the adjacent sheet metal parts. Now in 2024, we can right-click the copied part and select the new Propagate Slots option. We can choose which slots to propagate or simply choose all instances. Now when zooming in, we can see that the slots have been propagated to the adjacent parts. This is a huge time saver, since we can now reuse the tab and slot feature in assemblies. Now let's open the base plate and add the wheel indents. We can see that there is a fully dimensioned rectangle sketch already created. With it selected, we'll click the new sketch base stamp tool. We can now add dimensions to build out the dimensions of the first stamp. First, we'll define the depth of 20 millimeters. Then we can make sure that the tooling can be easily removed. So we'll add a 5-degree outward draft. Next, we can control the die and punch radii of the tool. We'll set those at 20 and 10 millimeters respectively. Finally, we will turn on the punch side corner radius option and set that to 15 millimeters. The new stamp tool is super powerful and any close contour sketch can be used to create stamps. In many situations, the stamp tool can be used instead of forming tools, which will save time and effort. There is another sketch in the tree, which is simply two-dimensioned points on the base plate. Using a sketch-driven pattern, we can pinpoint the exact locations of the other two wheel indents and pattern the stamp. Going back to the cargo carrier, we can see that there are two taillights that are mounted on the outer frame. Let's see how the sheet metal mount was designed using new functionality in SolidWorks 2024. This part is just an extruded, thin-walled cylinder. For this to be a flattenable sheet metal part, we would need to rip it first. Now, in 2024, the rip command can be used to rip thin-walled cylinders and cones. Simply choose the Ripp command and click the inner edge of the cylinder. Now, clicking a point will define where the Ripp feature will be. The Ripp dimensions can be defined by a linear distance, or we can dimension it by degree. We'll set this Ripp cut to 3 degrees and choose symmetrical so that we know it is centered on the point. We also have the option to offset the Ripp as well. Now, by using the Insert Bends command and choosing one of the inner edges, Ripp feature, we can define this as a sheet metal part and see the flattened geometry. By expanding the utility of the Ripp command, it is now easier than ever to convert thin-walled cylindrical and conic geometry into sheet metal parts. Hiding the sheet metal enclosure will allow us to see the structure system in full, including the corner connectors. Here are some of the great changes that have happened to structure systems in SolidWorks 2024. We'll create this structure system easily using these surfaces to gain our two rectangle elements. Deselecting the edges will remove the associated weldment being created. Secondary members are a breeze and only require our selection of the primary and secondary members and any planes that we may also want to build members with. If we neglected to deselect previously, simply selecting the member profile once it's been created and hitting delete will remove that member from our structure system. When exiting the structure system, we'll begin to notice some of the changes that have happened to structure systems in SolidWorks 2024. the property manager will change to corner management. We can now automatically apply corner grouping based off of a reference plane, like what we select here. In previous releases, we could group corners, but this was a manual process. It could be time-consuming working with a large weldment system. There are several new UI elements, and we have a new option as well, Open Corner. This addition allows for greater flexibility when creating your new weldment structure, and the possibility of adding additional unique end connectors, besides the other options that have previously been available. Another great enhancement for 2024 is the ability to allow units for properties. Taking any items in our cut lists and selecting the properties will allow us to add those units to our custom property. This isn't just for bodies or members on our cut list, but will also be for file properties. A good example is the adjustment of the mass. Simply right-click and change the units in the property window. We can now finish this weldment by mirroring several of the bodies from our cut list. With SolidWorks, it's easy to create complex weldments using more than just sketch lines, and Structure Systems has great tools to be able to do this quickly.